which players would you start your team with, build your team around, or keep on your roster at all costs? And so today, I'm giving you the definitive list of the five most untradeable players in the NBA. Right now, I've used a complex algorithm with millions of data points. Even Kirk Goldsberry was like, you gotta chill. But I will not chill. Numbers matter, potential matters, age matters, health matters, star power matters. So with that, here are the guys. It is Nikola Jokic at number five, having another statistically unheard of year for a big man. He's 26 years old. He's given you 26, 14, and 8, leads the league in almost every advanced metric. The best passer ever at his position, at least that we've seen in the NBA.
Arvydas Sabonis, buddy.
Yeah, but Sabonis we saw at the end.
Okay,
we saw it toward the end. This kid's in his prime.
Continue.
And he's keeping a skeleton crew in Denver afloat. That's number five. Okay, number four. Joel Embiid, who's 27 years old, a year older. He's putting together another MVP caliber season. He's dominant at the rim on both sides of the floor, leads the league in scoring, best low post move since the Dream, shoots 36% from three. His best teammate is on sabbatical. They're a game out of first in the East.
Sabbatical.
This dude is, who's ever at the center position had a better overall package of skills than Joel Embiid? Number three. Giannis, the reigning finals MVP, just put on one of the all-time NBA finals performances. He's a back-to-back regular season MVP. He's a seven-footer. He's dominant around the basket and unstoppable in transition. He just turned 27, and he could be leading his team to the finals again this season. I mean, yes, they were lucky. He was lucky that the Nets were all beaten up last year, but when he got to the big stage, he came up huge. At number two, Luka. Let me tell you something. Is he better than Giannis right now? No, but he's 22. He's a baby, and he's already the man. Luka, he's 26-9-9 this season. He's a 6'7 point guard who distributes, scores, the whole thing. And by the way, his shot's going to get better as he gets older. You could make a good argument his first four seasons. Maybe that's as good a first four seasons as anyone's ever had. It's way up there. Who's number one, you ask? Is that why you're looking at me that way?
Oh, no, I know who number one is.
Ja Morant, human rocket fuel. He's dunking on everyone, talking trash to the best players in the NBA, leads the league in scoring in the paint as a point guard, and he's turned the Grizzlies into a force in the West. Oozes star power, not afraid of the moment, might be the most marketable player in the NBA going forward. No, and look, I know that there's no LeBron James here, there's no Kevin Durant, and you can make an argument, even at that, at their age, they may still be. But, you know, KD is 34 next year, coming off the Achilles, and LeBron's 37. Jacoby, do I even have to ask about how great the list is? Perk, you look predictably thrilled. I'm going to go to Perk on this. What do you think, Perk?
Well, I'm not thrilled, and I'm not going to disrespect anybody on that list. I feel like they're superstars, but it's a difference, okay? It's a difference between superstars and megastars. And two guys that's supposed to be on that list is LeBron James and Steph Curry. And let me tell you why. I get it. In between the lines, and we talk about guys putting up numbers, but the only numbers that matter is those dollars, those million dollars, billion dollars. And when you talk about LeBron James and Steph Curry, that's what they bring to the table. So far as being untradeable, I'm never trading those two guys because they're bringing me so much money. Just think about this. The Golden State Warriors moved from the Bay and got one of the best arenas in San Francisco on the back of who? Steph Curry.
Steph. Okay.
How could you even think about not having him on the list?
Yeah, and with LeBron John James, see what happens.
It hasn't. You put LeBron James, I don't care if he's 45. He still sells the most shoes. He's number one in jersey sales. Matter of fact, didn't they just change the name from the Staples Center to Crypto.com? You don't think that deal had a lot to do with LeBron James? I mean, come on, Max.
Well, when you look at this list, you have to ask yourself, which one of these players can be the best player on a championship team?
I totally agree.
There's only one there, and that is Giannis. And I also believe that Joel Embiid fits that bill as well.
You don't think Luka or Ja could be the best player in a championship team?
I've seen them in the playoffs. Did you? Oh wait, you might have missed Ja in the playoffs last year because the stint was that short.
He was 13 years old.
And Luka Doncic hasn't shown it to me yet. One game he shot down the Clippers, and for
this
me,
this dude didn't get anywhere
Joel
in the playoffs his whole career.
7'3", shoots 36% from three, gets 1.5 blocks a game, and Joel Embiid right now, he's saying, you know what? I don't need Ben Simmons. I'm two games out of number one.
I'm not arguing against Embiid.
Joel Embiid to me is the number one on this list.
This dude never went anywhere in the playoffs his whole career until the Nets got hurt and they had to bring in reinforcements. They had to bring in Drew Holiday.
You haven't been